Hi and welcome back to another quick tip tutorial. I got this request to explain how I use alphas when sculpting and when using them for masking. So first of all, I'm going to be using Cube 3D for this quick tip tutorial. I will make a polymesh 3D out of it, and under Dynamesh I'm going to turn off blur and project and set 512 and Dynamesh it. And then just draw it out, holding shift to snap to the view, pressing T to go to edit mode, and here we go, we have a subtool that is 1.5 million points large. So when you are creating something with alphas, I always do this on Dynamesh, because the points get really stretched when creating some deformations, and Dynamesh is the perfect tool to solve these edgy looking deformations. So I just will select drag rectangular, and I'm going to, under alpha, import some alphas that I created earlier, and let me just select a bunch of them. And then I'm going to just draw it out, and as you can see here, well, let me do this again with a more intense setting, just to make sure what I'm trying to show is clear. As you can see here, because I have focus shift set to 0, the center is elevated more than the edge. If I would want to elevate this the same on all sides, I would have to set focus shift to 100 and then just draw out, and as you can see, it's perfectly aligned, and that was previously when I have focus shift set to 0. So focus shift really makes a difference. So let me just show you why I use Dynamesh, because now you can see we have this strange looking edge. These are the polygons that are really stretched, and this is not really what we are looking for. So under geometry, I make sure I have polish turned on, and I just re-dynamesh it by holding control and click and drag on the canvas, and some of these jagges will go away. And if I'm still not really satisfied with the effect that I got, I just go under deformation, and under polish by feature, I have this circle full, and I just polish it by approximately 50%, and you get a little bit more clear look. So this is it about creating these deformations with brushes, and I just want to show you the same applies with when you want to use alphas when creating masks. When you hold control, you switch to the masking pen, and you should also set this focal shift to -100, because if you would draw out a mask now, you can see the edges of the masks are getting really not diffuse, transparent, and you don't want that, because the deformation wouldn't be clear. So I'm just going to hold control and set the focus shift to -100. So make sure you're holding control when setting the focus shift for the masking pen. And now if you hold control and draw out the mask, you can see you get this crisp mask all around. So another thing, when you are drawing out the mask, you should just play around with the position of the mouse to position the mask accordingly. So the next thing I would like to show you is that you can use you can press shift and it will snap, it won't turn again anymore. So if you're holding shift, it will stay spot on where you started pressing shift, and it won't turn just like crazy. So just redynamesh it and polish it by feature, and you will get some more nicer looking design. So another thing about this using masks when creating subtools is when using ShadowBox. So I'm going to go to ShadowBox and set the resolution to 512 and click on ShadowBox. It will use this subtool because this is the only subtool that we have currently on the canvas, but we don't want that, so we're going to hold control and click and drag on the canvas to get rid of all the masks. And this is the ShadowBox that we currently have. So we just hold control and draw out a mask on one side of the ShadowBox, and it will create a subtool. Sometimes you just need to select some it plays around with me now. So you just make sure you get rid of all the masks on the canvas, on the shadow box. So just hold control and click and drag on the canvas a couple of times to get rid of them, and snap to the other side and get rid of this one and get rid of this one. Now it should work. Now if you would like to set the depth a little bit wider, just use this and hold Control Alt to get rid of some of the mask. So now you, when you turn off ShadowBox, you get this nice looking subtool, which you can use then when, for example, applying another subtool and then just moving this back and using, selecting the subtool that you created and using matchmaker BMM, and then just go over this subtool and it will deform according to this underlying subtool. So this is really nice when you want to use your subtool and you want to deform it according to this underlying subtool. You just have to make sure you get everything in a place. Sometimes you have to go over it a couple of times to get the result that you want, but this way you just kept the number of polygons on the canvas on the lower value than if you would go in and subdivide this sphere and then just draw out the mask that we showed earlier. So this was pretty much it for this tutorial, and make sure to check out the rest of my videos on my YouTube channel. Here are three of them that are really interesting, so check them out. Subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already. Comment this video, like it, share it, and till next time, bye.